Good morning, everyone. I am Kalyani Danare, and I would like to call upon Sharman and ask him a few questions.
हाय कल्याण।
Hi, Sharman. You are a school topper. How did you juggle your hobbies and co-curricular activities with your studies?
सो बेसिकली आई फील दैट द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट थिंग विच फुटबॉल टॉट मी वॉज टू ऑलवेज रिमेन फोकस्ड। आई थिंक बीइंग फोकस्ड इज वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट इन ऑर्डर टू एक्सेल। फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू आर सिटिंग इन द एग्जामिनेशन हॉल, यू कैनॉट थिंक अबाउट द गोल विच यू स्कोर्ड यस्टरडे। सिमिलरली, if you're warming up before match, you can't think about the pending assignments in school. So I think that being focused helped me to juggle both my academics and my co-curricular activities.
We always remember the teachers who were hard on us the most. In hindsight, have these teachers been pivotal to your success?
Yes, I definitely think that the teachers were an extremely important part of my success. Throughout the year, I felt that the teachers were hard on us for no apparent reason. But now I realize that without them reproaching me, I would not have achieved the marks that I got. So I think that the teachers were definitely an invaluable contribution towards my success.
What is an unconventional piece of advice that you would give the students?
So I feel that whenever someone mentions the 10th grade or the board examinations, there's suddenly an air of nervousness and tension. I would just like to advise the students to take part in all the inter-house events, the functions and the parties wholeheartedly. This may sound weird to most of you right now, but when you sit in the examination hall looking at the board question paper, you'll realize that it's one of the easiest exams you've given. So I would just like to advise the students to have fun and enjoy their last year in school. Thank you.
Thank you, Sharmat, for your wonderful advice. I now hand over the mic to Shrishti.
Thank you, Kalyani. I would now like to call upon Aditi so I can ask her a few questions.
Hi, good morning, everyone.
Hi, Aditi. So my first question to you is, failures are a part of life. What is the most important thing that you have learned from facing one in school?
Failures are tough as they hurt and leave us rejected. I experienced this after my first prelim when I got less marks than what I expected. It took a while for me to bounce back, but I could do so because of the ample support from my parents and teachers. What I learned through this is that asking for help during these times can help in overcoming setbacks. Because of this, I attended my second prelim. And the encouragement of my teachers during the study holidays also made me better equipped for the boards.
My second question. You joined school just 3 years ago. How would you describe your journey to the top of success?
I joined Pilot Truck in my 8th grade. It was a really big change for me. New city, new school and new friends. But in just a matter of days, I was comfortable in the school and among my classmates and teachers. The warm and encouraging students and teachers made this transition really smooth for me. And very soon, Pilot Truck was my school. The guidance of the teachers was also really good. Throughout my years here, they encouraged me to work hard. They stressed on regular work and consistent practice. They gave us tips on how to answer the questions. They encouraged us to solve previous year's papers and submit them for correction during the study holidays. They also made us note down important points and gave us details and keywords that the examiner would be looking for in the answer. The guidance and support of my parents and teachers proved invaluable during my preparation for the boards. Their belief in me motivated me to work harder. I am really proud to have been a part of Pilot Truck and I will always cherish my time here. Thank you.
Thank you, Aditi. I would now like to hand over the mic to Kalyani.
Thank you, Shrishti. I now call upon Atharva to answer a few questions.
Hello, everyone.
Hi, Atharva. How did the environment in class affect your performance throughout the year? And how did your teachers help you?
In class, I often found that there were many distractions. However, I tried to avoid losing focus as much as possible. I found that being concentrated and alert in class and listening to my teachers carefully really helped me in the long run. In addition to studying well, paying attention in the class is very important to to achieve good results, as teachers often give important notes during class. Throughout the year, our teachers took great efforts to guide us for our exams. They were stern, but at the same time kind, and made sure that I understood every concept thoroughly. They were always there to guide me and to solve my previous year's board papers. They also instilled values like self-discipline and hard work, and educated all of us on how to become good, respectable citizens in the future. They told us that the key to succeeding in the board exam was to study diligently, carefully follow their instructions, and above all, to remain focused and dedicated till the very end. Their constant, unwavering support went a long way in helping me and my classmates get good results in our exams.
You were quite consistent as a topper in school. Did you help your classmates when you had free time? If so, how?
Yes, I always tried to help my friends and classmates whenever I could do so. I would often help them in their homework. I would help them understand any concept or sum which they were unable to grasp. My friends would often ask me to help out with the project work or revision tests, and I would always be happy to oblige. My friends and I would always be ready to help each other out in times of need, so that each one of us would do well in the exams.
Thank you for sharing, Atharva. I now hand over the mic to Shrishti.
Thank you, Kalyani. I would now like to call upon Pranjali to answer a few questions.
Hello, everyone.
Hello, Pranjali. It is said that the children are clay, the teachers are potters, and the school is a potter's wheel. How true is this statement, and how has the school helped to mold you overall?
So, right from my primary classes, my teachers have always believed in me, which enabled me to gain confidence. They encouraged me to take part in competitions and enjoy the process rather than just being focused on the results. Conducting mass assemblies and doing group projects developed my leadership skills and taught me the virtue of teamwork. Principal Madam has been my role model in terms of public behavior. My teachers, my family, and my friends have greatly influenced me, molded my personality, and it is due to them, I think, that I could achieve this success.
My last question for you. What is one lifelong lesson you will take from school and your teachers?
It would be that we must never give up. So I was weak in English language and geography, but I trusted my teachers and did not take any tuitions, rather not for any subject. I followed their instructions and improved myself gradually. They solved the slightest of my doubts, were very approachable, and corrected the many papers I gave them towards the end as fast as they could. I'm very grateful to them for this. Thank you.
Thank you for sharing, Pranjali. I now hand over the mic to Kalyani.
I now call Maitreya to share some of his experiences.
Hello, good morning.
Hi, Maitreya. You have achieved 100 upon 100 in maths and social studies. Did you ever have trouble focusing on your studies? If so, what advice would you give someone who is facing the same problem?
Yes, I have had trouble focusing on my studies. While studying mathematics, I used to listen to songs and study, and while studying other subjects, I used to lie on the bed and study, eventually falling asleep and losing focus. For someone facing similar problems, I'll tell them three things. First, to do not be lazy, then only to do one thing at a time, and to get enough sleep.
What was the support you got from your teachers in academics and otherwise?
The teachers were always there for us. They never said a no to us even for the silliest of our doubts. They were really like candles who burned themselves down to give light to others. I initially used to hate subjects like languages and social studies, but it was only because of the constant support and encouragement that I got from them that I slowly started liking the subjects. Outside of the book, the teachers gave us many life lessons, inspired us to be neat and clean. Some teachers were more of friends to us than they were our teachers, and they also prepared us to face the real world once we left the school.
What are some fond memories of PTV that you will cherish forever?
Yeah, I have lots of fond memories of PTV and I will cherish them all forever. I had a sleeping problem in school. Wherever I used to sit, I just used to go to sleep. Jamis used to call me a hippopotamus for continuously yawning in class. I have been even thrown chalks at by Rakesh sir for this problem.
Even my mother has been called in school by Ramya Miss. Even my mother didn't know the problem. Well, the real reason was that I used to stay up playing video games till 1 a.m. and sometimes even till 3 a.m. in the night.
Thank you, Maitreya. I'm sure most of us can relate. I now hand over the mic to Shristi.
Thank you, Kalyani. I would now like to call upon our last student, Abha.
Hello.
Hi, Abha. What practical steps did you take to achieve your great success?
Firstly, right from the time the term started, I had one aim in mind, to complete the entire syllabus till Diwali, barring one or two chapters maybe. By and large, I could achieve that. And the next step was to write papers, lots of them. So initially, I started writing them like an open book test. And as I gained confidence, I started writing them like real exams, like setting the timer and all. This helped a lot. And after the papers were checked by the teachers, I would review them and note down all the mistakes I had made and pay special attention to them and the next time during revision so I don't repeat them again. Also, a very important thing is that I didn't bore myself too much by studying. I continued my hobbies, exercised well, meditated a lot, slept well, ate good food and just didn't stress myself too much. And also, after the exams, after each of the board exams ended, I did not analyze the paper. I did not analyze whether the paper was easy or hard. I just let it be and concentrated on the next one.
Your success is, to a large extent, tied to the efforts and support of the school teachers. How true is this?
It is very true. One important thing is that I knew that during classes, the teachers always tell us subtle hints or very minute details about how to write papers meticulously. So I paid full attention when they were teaching. And also, they were always there to answer my queries, even if they were very silly. So this they supported me and they trusted me. And that trust, the assurance that I can be one of the toppers if I studied hard, it greatly increased my confidence. And I'm also grateful to them for guiding me and other students as well. Initially, when I first saw the syllabus, my first thought was whether I will be able to complete all of this in 1 year. But then the systematic explanations given by the teachers that made it a piece of cake for me.
And my last question. What are some fond memories of PTV that you will cherish forever?
Obviously, the fond memories which I will cherish forever are the memories made by me and my friends together in PTV. All the joking, laughing, and whispered conversations during classes. All the free periods and all the silly games which we played, like pen fights and book crickets. I will miss all those. Actually, the thing is that I cannot list out just a few memories which I will remember because, frankly, all of them are very much liked. The institution, the teachers, principal, ma'am, I will miss all of them. And obviously, my friends too.
Thank you, Abha. I wish you the best. That ends the interview.